In this video, we'll learn about the characteristics used to describe market structures. We'll look at specific characteristics in turn and see how they may vary. In the next videos, we'll look specifically at market structures and how these characteristics apply. The number of buyers will influence the behavior of firms and markets. We concern ourselves with the number of buyers to understand the power of the buyer in the market. If a firm can offer its products to only one buyer, that buyer could have considerable market power and influence over price. However, if there are so many buyers, then none of them have any market power over price, and we move towards a more competitive market structure. Similarly with sellers, if there's only one coffee shop in town, the behavior of the firm will be different to a situation in which there were many more coffee shops. When there is a single seller, they have significant market power, but as the number of sellers increases, the individual firm typically has less and less market power. Products that firms offer can be homogeneous, slightly differentiated, or differentiated. For example, dollars in the foreign exchange market are homogeneous or identical when sold by different firms, whereas sports cars tend to be highly differentiated by producer. Slight differentiation can also exist, as is the case in the production of different basketballs. When considering the nature of information, we have to think about consumers and firms and their access to market knowledge. Perfect information exists when consumers are aware of all market prices and the benefits and costs of goods and services. This tends to be simpler for basic goods such as water and milk, but far more complicated when discussing significant decisions such as choosing a university to attend. Perfect information also requires that producers are fully aware of their own costs and have knowledge of their competitors' production methods. For example, no competitor can gain a competitive edge by developing a processing method that allows them to reduce costs without this information being accessed by competing firms immediately. Imperfect information exists when perfect knowledge is not available to help firms and consumers make optimal consumption and production decisions. This could be the case of information that is missing that gives a firm a competitive advantage against another. It could also be an information asymmetry that results from one party having greater information in an economic exchange. An example of this would be the purchase of a used car, where the seller would clearly have more information about the quality of the car as opposed to the buyer. Barriers to entry and exit limit the ease with which firms can enter and exit a market. This may be due to high startup costs, intellectual property rights, economies of scale, or high sunk costs. We'll explain those in more detail as we progress through the course. The more difficult it is to enter or exit a market, the less competitive that market tends to be. That wraps up this video on the characteristics of market structure. That's us done for now, and I will see you in the next one.